Hello and welcome to this Doctor Who special edition of Live Experiments, where I'm going to be having a look at what I think the science of this thing is, the Doctor's sonic screwdriver. Now, I'm here at the Faraday Lecture Theatre in the Royal Institution in London, and I'm joined by my companion for this adventure, Andy from the RI Channel.
Hello, everyone.
Now, as the number one Whovian on the Head Squeeze Gang, I was trying to think, what could we do for Doctor Who's 50th anniversary here on Head Squeeze? And I got thinking about the sonic screwdriver, and what I think, using logic, is how it works. Sonic screwdriver,
yep.
Sound, right? To control things. So that's why I gave Andy a call, because we've done a pretty cool experiment in the past demonstrating sound waves. So why don't you tell everyone what is going on here?
Sure, so what we've got here, this is a classic piece of science demonstration kit. It's called a Ruben's tube. It's a metal tube, tiny holes drilled all the way along the top, so that we can pump gas through it from the regulator here, and set fire to the gas as it comes out through these holes.
Very nice.
So that's quite pretty already, I think. But there's more to it than this. We can, as well as pumping fire through it, we can play sound through it.
Sound, of course, is a travelling pressure wave.
Yeah.
So if we're putting sound through here, the height of the flame tells us about the pressure at that point in the tube.
Yeah.
So by putting sound in, we're going to change that pressure and see what happens.
Yeah.
I thought we'd start with the simplest sort of sound that you can get, a pure tone or a sine wave, as we know in physics.
Yeah, okay.
So I've got a nice little generator on my smartphone here.
Okay, straight away we've got...
Standing wave.
Standing wave. So the standing wave is where the sound is coming out of the speaker, hitting the cap at the far end, bouncing back and interfering with itself. So it's creating this sort of system of nodes and anti-nodes.
Yeah, a standing wave because, of course, you're not seeing anything travelling. They're staying where they are.
Yeah, exactly.
So we have here we have an anti-node and there as well, where the flame's small.
Yeah.
And that's because the pressure is oscillating a lot.
Yeah.
And then we've got a node here where the peaks are.
Yeah.
And that's where the pressure is staying pretty much steady.
Yeah, yeah. And that's modulating the rate at which the gas is coming out of the holes and we're getting the different flame sizes.
Now we can change the frequency of the sound, frequency being pretty much the same as pitch, and see how that affects
it. Let's give that a go. Oh, wow.
So you can see it likes some frequencies and it doesn't like others. And that's called resonance.
Yeah.
Essentially, what you want is waves that have a wavelength that will fit inside the tube.
Yeah.
And that's the waves that it will try and kind of suck all of the energy from.
Yeah.
Whereas outside of resonance, you're not really driving it at the right frequency.
Yeah.
And so it doesn't like to take on all the energy.
Yeah.
That's all well and good.
Yeah.
It's not very Doctor Who, though.
Not really, no.
Well, it is a little bit Doctor Who. Now, he has used his sonic screwdriver in the past to control flames.
Yeah.
The girl in the fireplace, he put a candle on in that.
Yeah.
And I think also in the evolution of the Daleks, he lit a Bunsen burner. But I think we can do something more Doctor Who-y.
Yeah.
I think we can play the Doctor Who theme.
What could be more Doctor Who-y?
Exactly. And see it flickering in fire.
So we're seeing slightly different behaviour now, aren't we?
It's not a steady sound.
Yes.
So we're changing the notes all the time.
Yeah.
There's lots of different frequencies going on.
Yeah.
So the fire just dances to the music at those resonant frequencies.
Yeah.
That was pretty cool.
That was pretty cool.
I want to do something, though, that I've never done before with this Ruben's tube with you, Andy. I want to talk into the Ruben's tube.
You talk into the Ruben's tube?
Yeah.
You might inhale a bit of gas?
No, I've got a voice changing app. I thought we could do something a bit Dalek-esque.
This I can't wait to hear.
Exterminate! Exterminate!
Andy, thank you very much for hosting us at the RI.
I won't exterminate you.
I'm very grateful to the Daleks. So.
Well, thanks a lot, Andy, for having us at the RI channel.
Anytime.
No Time Lord, but I think we demonstrated some sonic screwdriver principles with this thing. If that's not enough Whovian science for you, head over to the Doctor Who channel where we recreate the original title sequence. And if you need to head squeeze, why not click on that subscribe button? Should we do the theme tune again?
Once more.
Let's do it.